This has been a difficult day for many people in Kamloops, British Columbia. They gathered for a memorial service to remember Robert Dziekanski, the man who died at the Vancouver airport. The CBC's Bonnie Allen was there. Bonnie, tell us about the mourners who showed up to pay their respects.
Jackie, almost everyone who came here today had never met Robert Dziekanski, yet they felt compelled to attend his memorial service and support his mother.
Good morning to you.
More than 200 people came early, filling the funeral home. It was standing room only.
Do you know the family?
No, I don't. We just wanted to be here as part of the Kamloops family and the Canadian family to say how much we care.
Our parents came from Poland, and in light of what's happened, you know, to support the family.
We lost her 8 years ago, so I can feel for her very much. She'll never be normal again.
Dziekanski's story has touched people across the country and made headlines around the world. The 40-year-old Polish immigrant died 11 hours after arriving in Canada. He spent that time confused and lost inside the Vancouver International Airport. He caused a disturbance. The RCMP used a taser to subdue him. He died shortly after. His mother, Sophia Krzyzewski, has been overwhelmed with grief. Many thought she would be too fragile to attend today's service. But in the end, she did come, leaning heavily on friends.
We're here in support of a mother who has lost her only son. You're here to honor the life of that son.
The few who did know him described Dziekanski as a quiet, thoughtful person.
People become good by doing good, Robert said.
But this service was also a protest against the use of tasers, as well as the actions of authorities that night.
People all over the world are taking note of the brutal side effects of this supposedly less than lethal form of subjugation.
After the service, Sophia Krzyzewski had this to say.
My family loved him so much. They cry all the time. They phone to me from Poland, and I love him so much.
Dziekanski has been cremated. His mother will keep half his ashes here in Canada and take the other half to Poland. This is not the end of it, though. It will take some time to sort out the full story of what happened to Robert Dziekanski. Jackie?
Thanks, Bonnie. The CBC's Bonnie Allen in Kamloops, BC.
Goodbye. Wait, like...
Thank you.